So guys, in this we're going to talk about how the arterial arches are formed. Now look at the radial artery. It is running on the lateral side, but instead of reaching the flexor retinaculum, the radial artery turns backward and goes into the anatomical snuff box. So let's say this here is the anatomical snuff box. So it becomes a content of the snuff box. And when it goes past the snuff box, it will go into the first web space on the dorsal aspect of the first web space where we have this dorsal interossei muscle. Now, like all the dorsal interossei muscle is bipinnate muscle, so it will go between the two heads of the dorsal interossei and comes onto the palmar aspect. The radial artery, it then continues onto the palmar aspect to form this arch that is a deep palmar arch. It came from behind, so it's quite deeply present, so we call it deep palmar arch. Also, this artery gives off the princeps pollicis artery. You can see it is supplying both the side of thumb, so we call it princeps pollicis artery. It's a principal artery of the thumb. It will also give off a branch which will run on the lateral side of the index finger, and that's why we call it radialis indicis artery. It is a radialis indicis on the radial side of index finger. So just see it again. We said radial artery goes backward without reaching the retinaculum into the snuff box, passes between the two heads of dorsal interossei, comes onto the palmar aspect, forms the deep palmar arch, gives off princeps pollicis artery, and also gives off this radialis indicis artery. So the first web space is supplied. Whereas on the other hand, if you look at the ulnar artery will run superficial to the retinaculum. You can see it is running superficial to the retinaculum, will go more distally in the hand and form the arch which is present at the distal palmar keys, called as a superficial palmar arch. Now this superficial palmar arch is a continuation of the ulnar artery, and it gives off this 1, 2 and 3 common digital artery. These are the 3 common digital artery. Well, clearly we call it common digital because it is further giving off the branches to supply the 2nd, 3rd and the 4th web space, and these branches are called as proper digital artery. So we have a 3 common digital artery here, and now we have the proper digital artery supplying all the remaining web spaces. Still something is left, that is the ulnar side of the little finger. So we have one proper digital artery coming all the way directly from the superficial palmar arch. 3 common digital, but one proper digital artery. Now, how this superficial and deep palmar arch are completed? Now, deep palmar arch, as you can see, it is completed by the branch of the ulnar artery. This is a deep branch of ulnar artery. Whereas a branch of radial artery will go superficial to the flexor retinaculum and completes the superficial palmar arch. Radial artery is not coming superficial to it, the main radial artery, but a branch is coming superficial to it to complete this arch, that is the superficial palmar arch.